To start us off, I want to talk a little bit about the conflict in Ukraine. For years, Russia has been the go-to adversary used for examples of electronic warfare in action, whether it's accusations of jamming or spoofing GPS, disrupting communications, or engaging in information warfare or cyber warfare. That's just the example that's been used. Over the last few months, I'm curious, what have we been able to learn about Russia's actual EW capability as opposed to what has been said over the last few years? Dave, I'd love if you could take this first.
Sure. I think it's interesting that when you compare the 2014 operations with what's going on now, it's a very different scenario when you're lined up on the border and you're doing operations from you're doing EW operations from the border but not going very far into the country. It gets very different when you're being mobile and you're trying to get into the center of that country. I think the EW coordination and synchronization becomes very challenging. You get into those urban scenarios, I think it becomes even more complicated. And I think what we're seeing in the Ukraine is a resistance that where the dependence of EMS isn't there in some of the kind of the more peer-to-peer operations that we would expect to see. So where you see the effectiveness of EW operations and where we see Russia being very good, potentially limited effectiveness against a neighbor where you're well into that country, you're very mobile, and the dependence on the EMS isn't there in kind of the more traditional fights that we see.
Is that what you would have expected coming into this, or is this something that we're sort of learning as it happens?
I think we're learning it as it happens or as it goes. I think there's a lot of learning going on about the kind of the state of Russian EW and kind of the Russian hierarchy in general as it relates to their defense. Seen a lot of open source information about some about kind of the state of how their budget's managed, about how well trained their operators are, and we all know that training for EW is a very hard problem. If you don't have well trained operators, then the effectiveness of those EW systems becomes difficult. If you compile that with forward moving operations, right, that challenges it even more. You're well embedded into the country. It's not something where you're lined up on the border. I don't think we expected it to the degree that we see it. I think we expected a much stronger EW presence. Which isn't to say that it's not there, but I think the degree of coordination and synchronization in these types of operations is such that the untrained operator will have a hard time pulling off those types of events successfully.
Tad, let me bring you into this conversation. What are you seeing today in Ukraine as opposed to what we've been talking about with Russia's EW capabilities in recent years?
Yeah, well, so I appreciate the question. And of course, getting into the details, what we're seeing day to day from the threats and intel updates, we can't get into those specifics.
Sure.
But to Mr. Tremper's point, I think anything that relates to electromagnetic warfare and a country's and a military's ability to execute that mission reflects some very interesting things. It reflects whether or not they have the technological capability to do that. And then, of course, more importantly, do they have the human capital to execute that mission? And there's no surprise that as we look to 21st century warfare, we're going to see an increase in electromagnetic warfare used, particularly in the beginning, to shape the operational environment. And then all through the course of the conflict, that's what we can expect, wherever that conflict may take place. In this case, in the European area of responsibility, and specifically in Ukraine, we're learning a lot about what Russia has been investing their money in, the sophistication of their equipment, the reliability of their equipment, and their soldiers and military members, personnel, with their ability to execute that mission in a synchronized fashion. And so I think it gives us some insight of where certain countries are, where we are, where we need to be, where we want to be. And that's certainly very helpful.